the kind of little competition that's going on at the moment with the last four teams, and if they beat the Netherlands, they can really go above that and be above both the Netherlands and Serbia. But the night, you guys can hear the carnage that is going on at the moment. The knife round is taking place, so we will be starting very soon. We're starting early because we're a bit out of schedule due to that long 15-15 match and also the pause that we had. But the Netherlands will win the knife round, so they're going to be starting off on the CT side. And I think Chris J has had to disappear due to the fact that he's got a game. But he's probably not too happy that they only secured 1 point. Oh, it's me again. What is going? Mate, I just swiped onto myself, and I'm watching the game, and I'm like, hang on a second, that doesn't look right. Yes, we're in the game. We've not missed anything. Just the knife round. But I mean, it's Cash. Tell me a bit about Cash here, Neil.
Yeah, it's a very open sided map. I think it's CT sided map. A lot of middle control. Teams who can get middle control will obviously probably win a half. I think it's a lot smoke based as well at middle. You're going to see a lot of action at middle, I think, in my opinion. I keep saying middle, but yeah. It's going to be a lot of boost action, I reckon, from both teams. I'm really looking forward to seeing what these two sides can do. I haven't seen any of these sides play cash yet. I haven't seen Spain play cash anyway, that's for sure.
Yeah,
what games they've played so far?
Yeah, exactly. We've not seen them play cash. Now, what is cash? I mean, what kind of map would cash be considered as far as the kind of tactics like what kind of style really works out in cash?
I think a lot of aggression towards the A site, middle, as I was saying. I think it's a very fast open map. You're going to see a lot of action quite early in the first 20-30 seconds of the round. I think you can be aggressive, as in pushing into A main with an AWP, getting quick control, a quick pick. You can do stuff like double push door on eco rounds. You might see that quite a lot. You'll see a lot of aggression kind of happen on CT. There's a lot of different styles you can have on this map. You can have a 3-1-1 dynamic kind of CT setup with three people up middle. You can give up middle and have the standard 2-1-2 kind of setup. So there's a lot of different CT setups you can have. So I'm interested to see, will Netherlands pick up a double AWP setup in this map?
I think right now Spain has actually a stronger lineup than they did against the Serbians. They've got Mixwell now, and also Dragunova did it all right yesterday. Even though the rest of his team weren't doing too well and they lost the two games that they played and also forfeited one. But it is the start here of this best of one, Netherlands versus Spain. We're going to have an hour break, or maybe actually less due to the delay, before the next match, which will be France versus Hungary, if I'm not mistaken.
I'm pretty sure you are right. I'm pretty sure you're right.
I think my memory is serving me correctly. But here's the pistol round. CT side will be occupied by the Netherlands, and already they're getting a lot of information over at B-Halls. Cash King pushing all the way forward. We do have Mike S back instead of... Oh, no, it's not. It's Amos who's going to be playing instead of Chris J. And the terrorists have complete control of the A-side, so they will be playing for the retake. But look, it's really smart here by the terrorists. They've got control, but at the same time, they've left two inside fifth column agents flipping in a great position to cut off these two CTs from rotating, and they're going to try and take him out. He absolutely demolishes Crucial and backs away. He's done his job. Kyrie's down, though, and now the CTs are actually heavily populating the A-site. Top catches one of them. They're pushing forward. Mixwell has to make the frag here. He's being attacked from a couple of corners, but the Glock in the close range is going to be the better of the two pistols. Mike S looking for more frags here. Flipping now supporting Top, and they're still alive. The time's ticking. There's not a lot of time left here on the CT side. It's just Lewis Remo. It's Flipping and Mixwell picking up a frag each. He's going to get a knife as well. Is he going to go for the defuse? Oh, but he's planted for main. He's going to get the frag, but not enough time to get the defuse, and he didn't even have time anyway. So a bit too late for the Netherlands, and Spain will pick up the pistol round.
Yeah, just a simple fast A there, caught the Netherlands off guard, or just had a free access into the A site, getting that bomb down quickly, and round one there by Spain. Great start for them anyway, but look at the money on Lewis Rivers. He had 3.7k going into this round, I mean.
Yeah, really nice knife, and weirdly enough, he's not even going to buy armor, while the rest of his team will. Maybe he's saving up for an AWP for the beginning, or for the first buy round of this map. Terrorist now moving towards the B site. They've left the bomb behind. It should be picked up though by Torp, and Dragunov will find himself with an entry. Two CTs over at mid, two coming in from the A site, and now they're just going to play for the retake. They can kind of maybe just attempt a save of their armor and pistols for the next round, which is going to be an eco anyway. But it seems like they were going to go for it. They lost Amos and then decided doesn't seem like it's going to work out.
Yeah, this is probably Mike S and Crucial going to save. Well, Crucial's not going to be able to save his armor in CZ. Cash King does pick up a kill though, so not a bad eco round so far for Netherlands. As you can see, Lewis Rivers, who got the knife kill, has got 3k, so obviously, like you were saying, he's probably going to drop the AWP on the fourth round. So, yeah, not a bad eco for Netherlands.
Indeed so, indeed so. And who do you how many rounds do you think you should expect to get on this T side on cash?
I think at least six rounds is very good. Five is good. Between five to kind of eight kind of margin is really good. That's what you'll be aiming for. Nine is a really, really good half, better than what you expected. So yeah, around that kind of area.
Right now, Spain picking up the second anti-eco, or the second round and the anti-eco. And now they'll get another eco, anti-eco, sorry. I'm confusing my ecos. They'll get a second anti-eco round against the Dutch. No stacks here from the Dutch, pretty standard play, but they've gone for a two-man push over at Squeaky, and they're going to be rotating and trying to flank the Spaniards. I think the Spaniards have read it well. They're just standing, staying behind, and waiting for that push that is coming from the CTs.
Yeah, but look at Netherlands here. Three people have pushed out of A here, getting full control. They're actually boosting. Look at Mike Hess here on the boost. Can he pick off a 17 HP carry who's inside team middle here? Not Ooh. Getting any information so far, Mike isn't.
He's in a corner, and if he goes down, it's actually 3 against 5. They're moving towards the B site. Mike S takes down Kyrie as expected. He's going to try and push in from the vents, but Dragunov is there ready and waiting for him. And now the T's will try to push towards the B site. Amos. He finds Torp and actually lands a considerable amount of damage as well. And the Spaniards looking a bit timid at the moment. Cash King over at vents with the AK-47 that he picked up. They have to be careful. If he starts getting frags now. There's 30 seconds left on the clock. They have to make their move sooner or later. So it's a really good push by the CTs. I think the Spaniards could have done a better job dealing with that eco round.
Yeah, Spain just taking their time here, just trying to make sure to get into the site, not lose any more men, because this is a dangerous round here. As you said, Cash King has got an AK on him, and he could do damage with his AK. So here we go. Can they retake this site? 3v3 here. No kits on the Dutch side, though.
Crucial. He's coming up from a great angle. Is Torp going to be ready for this? He pushes forward. He doesn't have a lot of health either, and that drops a weapon. It's an AK-47 and a MAC-10 versus flipping a Dragunov, but they've got the armor and the positional advantage. It should be easy pickings for them. Crucial tries to push forward, but he doesn't have a lot of health, and that's going to be the round for Spain. But a very good eco round indeed by the Netherlands, and at least they've done some economic damage onto the Spaniards.
Yeah, great recovery though by Spain there. 3v5 that actually was for Spain, but they just took their time, made sure they got picks one by one, and they slowly took that round off. That's 3-0 to Spain. Great start for them.
Yeah, not looking good here for the Netherlands on the CT-sided map at all. And Spain with the 1-1. I mean, the 1-1 between Serbia and Netherlands is perfect for Spain. It's absolutely perfect for Spain. And if they win this game, that'll put them 6 points up and in a pretty nice position to qualify to the round of 16.
Yeah, this is their last game.
Yeah. No, yeah, it is. It is. They'll have 6 points. I mean, they need this win, actually. They have to win. And the question is, though, Neil, that I wanted to ask you, is Spain capable of winning that round of 16 match?
Oh, yeah, definitely. They've got a lot of talent, as I was saying. They've got Kari flipping. Yeah, he's playing again. So, but Mike Esto, great headshot onto Kari there. But, yeah, they've got a lot of talent there, Spain. I was saying yesterday they had a very, very weak lineup, in my opinion. They could have put a lot better lineup like they have today. It was a good win against Serbia. But, yeah, if they beat Netherlands, they've got a chance. Depends who they play against, in my opinion. If they have someone who's like Sweden, they'd have no chance.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, the terrorists now moving towards the B side. They've already lost Kyrie to Mikas. Lucerov is going to pick up the frag. There's one more person in the side. He actually gives away his position. Then he's going to land right above his head, and it will end him flipping with a double there. Two entries on towards the B side. Bomb being planted by Dragunov. A nice position. I like this spot to plant it because you can just protect it from checkers. There's a good Molotov that forces him out. He's going to stay in the fire and burn alive. I don't know why he was moving off to the left. Maybe thinking that he was going to get killed by Cash King if he tried to come in from the right. But there's a man down. And now it's a 2v2 retake here by the Dutchman. He goes down. Mixwell takes him out. Mixwell jumps to the CT, and somehow Mike's is on the other side. Mike S is on the other side of that CT door or CT spawn kind of doorway. But Spain will pick up that round. They pick up the first buy. So really nicely done there by the Spaniards, and pretty close. It's 2v2, but the retake was a bit lackluster.
Yeah, not very good there by Netherlands there in that 2v2. Spain picking up that fourth round, and they're 4-0 up already on a CT side of map. Spain will be absolutely delighted with this start.
Yeah, indeed so. Excellent. 4-0 on the T side is great. Really, really great.
And what do you think? Do you think Spain are going to run away with this, or do you think Netherlands have got a way back into this? I think Netherlands still have got a chance, but flipping opens up that round on Lewis.
It looks like the Spanish have got this game, really. I mean, with this
think
round,
so, yeah.
When it's 5, yeah, I think they've got it. But we've seen 5-0, then 10-5. We've seen that.
Yeah.
I've seen that a
of
lot
course,
of cash.
Yeah.
Cash is one of those maps, so you can do that. But they just look on point now, Flippin and Kyrie, as well as Mixwell. This is a really nasty combination of Spanish players. They're very, very dangerous. And Netherlands without Chris J are just suffering at the moment.
Yeah, definitely. Chris J, as we've seen two sides of Netherlands there against Serbia. Didn't look great at all against Serbia in the first 10 to 12 rounds. And then when Chris came in, he really stabilised them. And Netherlands looked like a force. But here we go again. We've got Amos in for Ketchup, actually, who's not playing this game. And as you can see, bottom of the scoreboard here, 1 for 5. Not having the best of times. But Netherlands are going to change it up here. We've got a double up set up here for Netherlands.
Yep. Right now, this is one of the kind of turning points of this game in terms of changing the momentum from the Spanish side to the Dutch one. And with two AWPs, this would be the moment, but my oh my, we just missed those two entry frags by Mixwell over towards mid, and already the CTs are down to 3. Crucial, though, using that AWP well, taking a frag. Can he return the deficit? Can he make it back to a 3-on-3 as the terrorists now push towards the B site? They smoke off Luis Revo. He needs to switch out his position. Maybe he can flash himself through towards the B site, but he's being attacked from behind now. Mixwell, who's already taking control of mid, is going to find himself with a free frag as he takes down Luis Revo. Oh, he turns around! He gets the spray down as well! Luis Revo with a fantastic kill, and that's a huge mistake from Mixwell. The bomb's going to be moving towards the A site anyway. And Kyrie just getting ready to open that magical door to Narnia. He finds the entry here on Clash King. The bomb's going to be planted as well. And now it's a 2 versus 3 retake for the CT. 1 versus 3 as Luis Trevor goes down. Crucial on his own with the AWP. And it's not going to be that turning point that we expected to see from the Netherlands with that double AWP setup.
Now, great opening 2 frags there by Mixwell. Almost screwing it up there by that failed whiff attempt there onto Luis Rivas, but lucky enough that won't cost him the round. The Spain take a round quite easily, in my opinion. Again, that's 6 rounds in a row. And oh my god, I can't believe it's 6-0 already on Terrorist on Cash. I did not expect this at all.
So fast as well, so super fast. And this is making the Spanish T side look quite scary. The Spanish T side is looking very, very scary indeed, and very fast and I'm just going to say it, brutal at the moment. And Netherlands just cannot deal with it. They're getting entry frags all over the map. And those mid entry frags by Mixwell, they need to know how to deal with it. They need to know how to keep mid control or just give away mid every single time as long as they keep people alive. But this is not a bad force buy around here, as Crucial and Amos have both picked up a frag each on different parts of the map. They've got mid control. The Terrorists are going to move in from the A site now from main with 3 players. 1 coming in from Squeaky. That's Flippin. He opens up the door. Crucial hears that. And now they're going to try and hold the A site. They've picked up an AK-47 on Amos. He's also got an armor, and it's the right call and a great rotation. And right now, Spain should realize, okay, we've sold them an A push. Maybe it's time for us to back away.
Again, they're just going to regroup here. Of course, they want a 3v5 if you run. No, they're going into A site. Dragunov, can he pick up this kill? No, Crucial gets a nice headshot onto him. Flippin gets the reward here for killing Kaskin. Can he pick up another? Does pick up another one. Actually, that was an assist. Torp does take that frag. 2v2 here.
Yeah, really nicely done. And most of those still has the armor and AK-47. They need to go for this. I mean, Netherlands, they've given away too many rounds already, Neil, haven't they?
Yeah, they have. It's been a disastrous start for them. Not what they wanted at all on the favorite CT side. They won the knife match. They wanted CT get off to a good start, but it hasn't happened. They really need to pick up this round. Look at Torque, though. Look at Torque.
Luis Arevo doesn't find that entry. Amos gets one, but there's return from Flippin. And they've played it really smart here, Spain, taking their time, waiting for the CTs to make the move. And with that, they're able to get the bomb planted. Luis Arevo, I think, is going to back away and maybe try and pick up the AK-47 that Crucial's had, and then try and go for it. Flippin, planted for main, backs away. And Luis Arevo, I mean, as soon as he sees that bomb plant, he knows, look, it's planted for main. Just check main straight away.
And just hasn't, I don't know why he hasn't at all, just no sense at all to check main. And look at Flippin, 17 for 1, and we're only 7 rounds in. That is absolutely unbelievable.
And it's been fast. It's been really, yeah, really fast. The rounds have been very fast. So, super blitzkrieg here by the Spaniards, and 17 in Netherlands are not looking good at all without Chris J.
No, they're not at all. No kind of experienced kind of person in Chris to kind of bring these guys through, and it's clearly shown at the moment, 7-0. Is there any way back in for this game? They really need to get some rounds on the board, and now, to be honest.
Yeah,
they need
and
to start now.
Exactly, and it's making their kind of group stage campaign a lot harder if they do lose against Spain. 1 point against Serbia, it's actually good because it's better than loss, but it means that they need to win against Hungary and that they need to win either France or Ukraine, which are two big, big teams. So that really makes their campaign more difficult. And Spain, with these two wins, if they win this game, really giving themselves a chance to qualify. It's four teams out of six that will be able to qualify to the round of 16, and then eight teams out of 16 to go to the LAN finals. Dragunov now pushing towards the site, knows that maybe somebody's going to be coming in from vents, and Moses right there. That Molotov is going to dissuade him, though. There's the CT smoke, and the bomb's going to be planted now. Two players here could be double kill for flipping if they line up for him, but Kashkin's going to take him out. Now it's a 3v2. They've got the man advantage, and it's two orbs actually in the site, so there's the opportunity to get the retake.
Yeah, it's going to be extremely hard for Spain here with these double up here to pull this site. Can Netherlands get their first round on the board? And great headshot there by Amos to make it a really good chance. And there we go, two kills by Amos. First round finally on the board for Netherlands, finally in the game. Yeah, that's really good. Thank God they got around, to be honest. I don't want this to be a whitewash, that's for sure. You don't want to see that in any kind of games.
Well, it's good. I mean, I think they're of the caliber of having the ability to come back, having the ability to pick up a couple of rounds in a row. We saw that against the Serbians. I mean, okay, fair enough, they had Chris J, but still, it was a collective team effort, and we saw Lewis Trevor really change his game as well in the second half of the match. But, Spain, they're already in a perfect position with seven rounds on the T side this early on. They're just really confident, really calm, really relaxed, and you don't want to have a relaxed T side with your opponents.
Good opening kill there by Crucial, though, onto fourth. Great opening kill there. That's exactly what Netherlands needed. And all you have to do now is just chill. You don't need any more information at the moment. Don't get picked. You've got the advantage. Spain needs to come to you. So don't get picked off. That's Mike S there. Great kill. Two kills by Mike S there.
Fantastic. Fantastic counter boost there by Mike S. Really nicely done. And that's pretty much the round for them. Netherlands looking a lot more sharper, and if they continue this, they might actually force the terrorist onto an eco sooner or later. And I think this round is probably an eco for them, actually. Spain should take it easy and just save. Maybe they can buy armor on like top and Mixwell, kind of save them, equalize the money, or get some utility. But they'll purchase some stuff, but they will go for an eco this round. And 7-2, it's good for Spain, but the Netherlands do have a chance now to come back.
I think we both know how quickly momentum can change. So that was a clean round for Netherlands, and they've got a little bit of money on the board now. That's how quickly momentum can change. Like, this is going to be massive now. Netherlands need to win this and not struggle and lose against these Tech Nines here.
Yep, indeed. So there's the smoke renewed over at main. Oh, and a spray down through the squeaky. Nicely done there by Cash King. Fantastic. He's got support from Crucial as well. Mike S landing some shots through the smoke on top. There's a return from Kyrie. Crucial's just going to push forward to the C7, and he gets himself a wonderful double as well. We got ourselves some nice highlights here. Let's see then again. Very, very nicely done there by Crucial. And that makes it 7-3, but we will see a full buy from the Spaniards.
Yeah, full buy for the Spaniards. As you said, AKs across the board here for Spain, and they're probably going to try and go for that middle presence again. It's been very successful for them a few rounds ago. Mixwell opened up with two nice headshots, so I think they might try and go for that middle presence, which it looks like they probably will do.
Indeed, so it worked for them, especially when Mixwell was getting those entries. Gate pop flash here by Cash King, but he won't be able to convert that into two kills as Dragunov will take him down in return. Mike S, though, with the exchange, and that's a huge mistake from Spain. I don't know why Dragunov was pushing forward with the bomb on his own, dropping the bomb like that in main. CTs just need to rotate now and need to make sure they don't get shot by Mixwell from mid like that. Loose Revo down, it's back to a 3-on-3.
But Amos is probably going to pick up this kill. He does. 2-on-2 now. Amos with two great kills there. Really, really good there. But Flippin is probably going to get this bomb down. Can he hold this? 2v1. Massive round if Spain win this.
He just gets the bomb planted and moves out of position. So 1v2. He's a very experienced, very good player. Great aim. Can he convert this clutch? There's the pop flash, and wow, shot there by Crucial. And we'll be able to make that kill and get the defuse as well. It seems like the momentum has completely shifted towards the Netherlands side, and now it will be 7-4. If they can continue like this, they might end up winning the first half at least and making it 8-7, even though, okay, it's not the perfect round score to be in, but with us being 7-0 deficit and coming back like that, it's huge momentum coming into the second half. And we saw the Netherlands, even on Inferno, they can have a pretty good T side.
Yeah, that's right. Anything can happen. As you said, Cash isn't as big a side of the thing as Inferno. It's not. It's more you can just run around and use your individual skill. And Inferno, it's more like smoke and Molotov based. But yeah, it's interesting to see if Netherlands can pick up these last four rounds. I think they need at least three rounds to have a good chance of winning this game.
Yeah, we'll see. Mike S just on the other side of that smoke. He'll be able to take down Kyrie, who tried to do a cheeky jump over there using that box. Good pop flash by Mike S, but there's a return. He's picked up two kills. I mean, he's done his job. Maybe got a bit too aggressive and a bit too greedy, but it has been to their benefit, as they do have the man advantage now. And the terrorists haven't really been going to the B site for a while now, especially after the Netherlands picked up that first round. I don't think they've actually gone to the B site at all.
No, they haven't done much at all, to be honest, for the B site. Well, some of the eco rounds, that was it. But yeah, we'll see. They are going to go B here, change it up a bit.
And they pop flash themselves through. There's one person at checkers. Actually, nobody at the site at the moment. Amos has to be careful. Maybe he should just time it, wait for his teammates. Should just stay there and wait for his teammates to come in and then play for the retake. I think that's the best idea. But there's the CT smoke. Bomb's going to be planted now. There's one CT over at the A site. He should be rotating soon as well. Crucial's got an angle inside top. He's going to take down Amos, who just held his position but wasn't able to win that one versus one. And two CTs now will try and push in from the balcony. Crucial finding the frag on flipping. Dragunov aware that somebody's going to be coming in from balcony. Two players now from CT, and there are no smokes left on the terrorist side. No utility to use as well. So they're just going to have to try and duke it off here with the M4 and the AK-47 that they have. It's just up to top now. He gets another kill. Can he make it three now? Kashkin going in for the retake, and Kashkin will find him. He's not even got enough time to go for the bomb plant anyway, but Kashkin makes sure that he doesn't get it, and that's 7-5. But it could have been actually a big gamble there by the Netherlands. I mean, had he peaked and top was just going for the kill and be like, all right, I don't have time for the bomb, he might have just given away the round there.
But the right choice for Kashkin. He got the round win, and that's five rounds in a row for Netherlands. Exactly what they needed. To be honest, I think they need to get the last three, though, in my opinion.
Yeah, they can't really. They don't have room for any more mistakes. Crucial, I don't know how he missed that shot there, but it's an anti-eco. Should be an easy affair for the Dutch players. And it's quite incredible how the momentum has completely changed. You know, you do not really expect that a team 7-0 down will be able to get six rounds in a row here. Oh,
no scope. Crucial going for the no scope.
Yeah, it's not landing. Amos is going to finish off the job regardless. And it's 7-6. Two more rounds left here on the first half before we see the side switch. And we're seeing a much more solid Dutch side.
It's a game of two halves in this first half, with Spain taking the first seven rounds and Netherlands coming back and winning six in a row. It's just crazy how momentum changes so quickly. It's just great half so far.
Yep. Indeed so. Right now, we do see a full buy from the terrorists. Aggression from Kashkin, which is pretty badly punished. Dragunov is actually going to get the better of Mike S. That counter boost, it worked out for them before, but it doesn't work for them now. There's a kill, though, by Crucial on Kyrie, who got a bit too over-aggressive on the A side, and Amos almost putting it back down to an equal measure. However, he's now stuck in this corner, and the terrorists, they can push him from main and from the boost place at the same time. He's pretty much a sitting duck, as Dragunov knows, and he's got his crosshair perfectly poised. Crucial now looking towards halls as the terrorists get control of the B site. There's the smoke going on. Dragunov getting the entry on Luis Trevo. And the bomb's going to be planted. Spain, two men ahead. And maybe some small mistakes at the beginning of the round. Maybe that cost the Netherlands this penultimate round of the first half.
Yeah, to Spain, exactly what they wanted. They wanted to get at least eight rounds, and that's a great half from them so far. If they get nine rounds, that is spectacular by them. It's more than what they expected. So yeah, it's going to come down to this last round. Netherlands really need it more than Spain need it.
Indeed so. Netherlands, though, after picking up so many rounds in a row, do have money for the last round of the first half, so it's not too bad for them. And they've actually opted for a double op setup. That's the Molotov. They needed to throw that. They need to throw Molotovs and nades. They need to put the pressure on the guys on the boost. They can't allow Dragunov to play that boost area or Mixwell to play that boost area with full confidence and full flair. He's going to be peeking main. There's nobody there at the moment. Got one person, my guess. He's got a great position, actually. Finds Dragunov's head, but doesn't finish the job. And Kyrie takes on Amos, who tried to finish him off as well. So Mike S has to make the return. He doesn't. They lose those one versus one duels on the mid. And that's pretty much them losing the round here. Really, really nicely done there by Kyrie to pick up those two.
Yeah, great two frags there by Kyrie. But Kashkin does take out Kyrie. Small bit of a chance here for the Dutch players. Dragunov is only on 10 HP, but it looks like they've got to set up to try and get in access to the A site. We're crucial here, sitting here, but in the site with the AWP.
Yeah, they've made a right choice to move towards the A side. They've left Mixwell as well to cause havoc over at B, and it's all up to Crucial now. Oh, he doesn't land the shot. It's not Chris J, but can Crucial make do with what he has. It's a 1v3, and it's the last round. He has to go for it. There are terrorists all around here. He's switching angles. It's probably not too much avail, as Dragunov will take him out with the Tech 9. 9-6. It's an excellent first half here from the Spaniards. Netherlands with a, you know, pretty nice comeback at one point in time, bringing it back to 7-6, in fact. But they lost the last two rounds, and this is going to give Spain a lot of room for the second half and a lot of confidence as well. It is pretty CT-sided, as far as I'm concerned.
Hey, but Netherlands were 9-6 down against Serbia on the favourite side, and they came back and got a draw. So they're capable of coming back. They showed that they had a strong T half on Inferno, so they could do it again on cash.
Yeah, indeed so. Well, they will be on the T side now, the Netherlands. Will we see anything different? They're actually pushing four players from Squeaky towards the A side. It's a good choice by them, but they have to play quick before the CTs figure this out. They're going to be pushing forwards the gate. Great pop flash, and they're all going to go towards Bialy. This is an excellent bit of tactics here. Kyrie and Mixel, they're going to pick up a frag each before going down top with a frag all the way towards mid. So it's a 2v3. Dual elites are going to go down as Crucial gets shot, and it's just Lewis Trevor on his own. Great retake here by the CTs. They're completely on point at the moment, the Spanish, and they're landing their shots. Fantastic. Flipping, taking down Lewis Trevor, and there you have it. It's 10-6.
Yeah, that's exactly what Spain wanted. The Netherlands are in trouble here. Will they force blow Tech 9s? I think they should do, which they have decided to do. They want to break. It's very common in CSGO for that to happen. Even when you don't have the bomb down, or when you're in a sticky part in this game, 10-6 down on the non-favoured side, it's a good decision for Netherlands to do this.
Right now, I mean, Neil, what can the Netherlands do? When you're this behind and playing on the harder side.
I think they need to take up an AWP on either Mike S or Crucial, but it seems like Mike hasn't been open that much. It seems to be Lewis Rebels and Crucial open. So maybe just get Crucial on the boost, get some information, try and get him to get some open picks for that AWP. Let him just have run around and try and get some picks. He's going to be the reason if Netherlands do get into this game.
Well, we'll see what's going to happen here as they do get ready for an A split. They've got a couple of players towards mid. It's good by them to get that mid control, but staying behind like that, allowing the CTs to have the long range advantage, they should go straight right up in their faces with those Tech 9s. Go for that movement accuracy, take full advantage of that. And look at this, we've actually got Mixwell over at Bialy, Lewis Revo, getting ready for the call. The bomb's going to be coming in from Squeaky as well, and they're going to be attacking from a lot of angles. This will be difficult for Spain to defend. I don't know if they're going to be able to do it. Kyrie with a 180 degree turn, and he's going to pick up a frag on Lewis Trevor. They have to continue pushing. I don't know what Amos is doing, just hiding towards main there. He needs to push forward, run forward at the CTs, get those entries, get those trades, and get the bomb planted. And well, they give them a bit of room to get the bomb planted here, the Spanish. I think they're kind of overestimating what the two remaining players have, but that P90 is going to be picked up here by Mike S. He's stuck in this corner. It's not a great plant either, and now it's a 2v3. He's going to pick up a frag, make it a 2v2. Amos is going to go down towards main. Now it's just Mike S in a 1v2, and flipping will give him no chance, no quarter, and no mercy as Spain make it 11-6.
That was poor there by Amos, as you were saying. He's just sitting there in A main, not even helping his team out at all, and then he just over peaks at quad there to just give a free kill for Spain. That's just poor play by him, showing he's inexperienced there, and that's really cost Netherlands a massive round there. It's going to be really, really difficult for them to actually win this game, in my opinion. As you can see, P250s across the board here for Netherlands, just going to eco for next round here.
Yep. It seems like we're seeing a really different Spain to the one we saw yesterday, Neil.
Yeah, definitely, but it's the lineup change, to be honest, in my opinion. It's a complete lineup change.
Exactly.
Having Flippin and Kari in, two great players, it really changed it for Spain.
And, you know, that's the difference between the top tier Spanish players and perhaps the second tier Spanish players. It's a world of difference, it seems. Right now, these legends of the Spanish scene, of the Espanol scene, are keeping the hopes high for Espanol.
Yeah, definitely.
Mixwell, fantastic by Mixwell. What a wonderful triple kill there with the MP7. Great control of that weapon. And that gives him very much control of the round. It's just Cash King on his own. Picks up a nice P250 headshot on Mixwell. Puts an end to that crazy, crazy player. But Dragunov will make sure that Spain will win that anti-ECOT. 12-6 now. They're only four rounds away from securing another 3 points. And it's a shame, because Spain, had they had this lineup yesterday, we would have seen more interesting matches, and we would have seen perhaps Spain's 100% securing themselves a spot in the round of 16. I mean, like this, they're still going to depend on the other teams not getting the 6 points.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They had a terrible first day with three games played and three losses. So probably that's the worst case scenario, obviously, for Spain. But I think they could just about sneak into the top four with these two wins. It might be enough, but we'll see in the next game, Hungary against France. If Hungary make a massive shock, that's not good news for Spain.
Yeah, right now they need to hope that Hungary lose all of their remaining matches in the group stages of Group B. By the way, guys, you can watch Group A over at eFrag TV 2, where Blue will be doing the hosting and commentary. And he'll continue doing the commentary for the other group matches as we do the other groups as well. Excellent pop flash. But Kairi, oh! Cashing just firing away because he can't see anything. And that gives away his position. Kairi with a triple. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. What a great pop flash over at Squeaky. And that's just an easy round for them.
Yeah, that's it. The Netherlands are in a world of trouble here. I cannot see them coming back now. Spain have got this under lockdown. Four quick rounds, one for Spain. And Kairi, sorry, Flippin is on 21 for 7. He is playing absolutely outstanding for his country tonight.
Indeed so.
Well, yeah, definitely.
Replay this is, oh yeah, it's Mixwell's triple. There you have it. Really nicely done by Mixwell. At the moment, it's not looking too great as the Netherlands are forced into yet another eco. It's a good start by Crucial, though, as he gets an entry. A lot of nades being thrown over those boxes by the Spaniards. They're turning it into a bit of a battlefield here, the A site.
Yeah, it's just freely free, though. They've got a small chance of winning this round, but Mixwell here, he's probably going to clean up here and takes that one, but he's missing his shots here onto Lewis Revo.
Just slightly as well. He's going to finish off the job regardless, and he'll push forward with the USB. It's just Crucial on his own. Somehow Mixwell survived long enough to get those two kills, even though he completely faffed the spray down. And at the same time, that really tells you a bit about the fact that the Netherlands are not landing their shots either. We're not seeing those crisp entries as they're moving towards the site, which they need on the T side. So as it is, they've not been able to pick up any T side rounds. And it might be a shame because we could see a 16-6 here by the Spaniards if they lose this buy round. So this is their last opportunity up on Crucial for AK-47s. Will we see something different here from the Netherlands? They can go for that mid boost, put that up on top, hope for an entry. And it seems like they're going to go for three men there. CT's not throwing any utility.
No, nothing at all. Just giving him a mid, really, and Froper has got picked up the opening frag on Mike S. But can they get the repeat? No repeat entry for Netherlands. That's just an easy pick for them. That's 5v4 already. Already Netherlands on the back foot here.
Yeah, I don't know. You can't. It just doesn't look like they're playing as a team at the moment. They're not very well coordinated.
No leadership, mate. No leadership at all, to be honest, in my opinion. No Chris J to kind of help him out, guide him out.
Yeah. And that confidence, knowing that you have a player like Chris J who can cover up any mistakes you make and, you know, carry the slack. Spain, however, looks really on point at the moment. Really, really on point. These guys are landing their shots. They're holding the right positions. They're making the right decisions. And that's a big part of CS is good decision making.
Yeah, definitely. Another kill there. Great. But fantastic. Great double kill by Amos there.
Yeah. Fantastic. But Dragunov, they're going to line up for him. And he makes it. Takes down one of them. That was actually crucial. The first guy who was spraying down survives, but perhaps not for long as Dragunov has his crosshair placed just a couple of millimeters away. And it's 1v3. There's not much that Kashkin can do at the moment. Perhaps he can try and cash in that AWP for the next round, but then he'd just be playing for a draw and he has to go for it. 17 seconds left on the clock. I think at this point in time, the Netherlands know that they've probably lost this game. And as it is, two games and only 1 point by the Netherlands, it's not too bad. Not too bad at all.
No, not at all, but obviously not the start they wanted. Of course, they probably expected to beat Serbia, in my opinion, which they didn't. That's a disappointing result for them. They're getting, to be honest, absolutely trashed here in the second half. They haven't picked up one round so far. So, yeah, Spain's looking good. Two wins, but Netherlands do need to pick up at least one more win here out of the remaining three games they have. And they've got some hard games coming up.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is that unlike Spain, they've got one draw, so that if they win two games, they'll have more points than them. But the thing is that the Netherlands have pretty tough games ahead of them. Hungary is probably a game that they can win, even though Hungary looked really strong. But France and Ukraine, that's going to be difficult. Top coming in from short here, picking up a frag. And now it's a 3v4. Kairi, whoa! I don't know how he survived that. He finally gets shot down by Lewis Roberts. A nice double by him. And there's a kill by Mike S as well from mid. And right now, Kashkin I mean, he can make a decision to go towards the B site. That smoke is... I don't know why Flippin put that smoke down, because that's allowed Cash King to get access into the site, and he can actually get a main plant quite easily as well. But they've made the decision to send off Mike S towards the B site and secure it, perhaps, or maybe to fake it, or maybe to pick up a frag, and then they can make their decision. So Cash King's just going to hold his angle here with the AWP and wait for something to happen.
Yeah, he's just waiting for Spain just to make a mistake, maybe just push here, to be honest. So it's going to be interesting to see if he can pick something up, but...
Yeah.
Dragunov does pick up Cash King there, 2v1. Mike S to save the day here for him. He does take down the first guy, that's a good start for him. HP though.
It's all on Mike S's shoulder now to try and stop this from turning into a slaughter on 16-6 scoreline. I don't know if he has any idea. He turns around. I think that... what sound did he make right there? He made a sound.
He doesn't even know that. He's killed him. Look, he's running around. He's no idea, but killed him when he was blind on a solo. 1 HP. Mike S with the clutch. Fair play to him. They took their first round, and that's 15-7. And round difference might come into this.
Was that like the flash noise that he heard? The pin
or
something?
It was.
Like he just turned around and just went and just fired away and he got himself a kill. But 15-7, I guess it improves the scoreline. I guess the Netherlands can also play for a 15-15, but it's a long, long adventure and a long, long campaign for this map if they want to do that.
Indeed, they need another 8 rounds to go here to try and win this. Draw for them, if it's possible. I'm not sure if it is. I don't think it is. It's probably about a 2% chance, but you never know in CSGO.
Yeah, you never know what could happen. They did a great job against the Serbians. It should have actually been their game, 16-14. But they've had a good start, as they're probably going to pick another round. And with the way the economy is, if they win this, it should be an eco for the Spanish top. Finds one, pushes forward. He's got support from Kyrie over at Balkan. He's going to come and support him over and check. And he lands a shot on Amos. I don't know how that happened. They won't have enough time for the defuse, but at least they might. I spoke too soon. They won't be able to take the final gun. Loose Trevor will survive. I think he tried to pick up the AWP, but he didn't have enough time. And the Netherlands will be able to get a full buy this round, while Spain will be on an eco. So it should be 15-9.
Yeah, Netherlands here, 2 rounds on the board and getting that 15-8. And as I was saying, round difference could come into play in this group because it's getting extremely close down there at the bottom.
Well, let's see. Cash King looking for an entry here over the halls. They're keeping their distance against these ecoing CTs. They don't want to be rushed down by any stacks or pushes. So they're looking a bit more on point now. They're landing the spray downs. They're landing the shots.
Yeah, well, maybe it might be a bit too little too late, to be honest. They've got 6 rounds to go after this to try and even get a draw. So it's no room for mistake. Take one round at a time and see if you can get as many rounds as possible on the board.
15-9. 6 rounds to get a draw. Spain, all they have to do is just win one. So, I mean, it would be one of the...
Simple as that.
Yeah, I mean, it would be one of the biggest comebacks in this tournament if the Netherlands... I mean, they won't be able to win, but if they come back from 15... What was it? 6? 15-6. I think it was 15-6. The one, hang on, let me see.
Yeah, it was 15-6.
Yeah, it was 15-6, from 15-6 to get a draw on the harder side. It would be one of the bigger comebacks. I mean, we've seen some crazy comebacks in the Asian qualifiers, but I mean, this would definitely be a top 3 comeback from the Dutch players. So we'll see. This is kind of a test to their mental acumen and consistency and ability to grind out rounds.
Well, that's a good start for Netherlands there. Mike S picking up the opening frag there onto Fort there. Great headshot for him. That's exactly what Netherlands need. They need to try and win this round, put Spain back on eco.
They're getting ready to push towards the A site. There's only Kyrie here. He does have support coming in from Mixwell over at short, while Mike S is just holding the flank at mid, or near main, actually, on the boost spot. There you have it. The utility thrown in by the Dutch players. And I don't know why they're running back after getting flashed by the Spaniards, and that's just giving away the round for them. Fantastic by Mixwell, and a fantastic flash as well, but you just have to run in. You're completely flashed, just run in and spray away and hope for something to happen, because you just have to make the trades. But backing away like that really put them in a bad corner and allowed them to get shot down by Mixwell. And oh my goodness, Mixwell actually taking down Mike S. It was pretty much Mixwell's round there. Four kills, and now it's a one versus one. Dragunov, he's got just 12 health to deal before Spain can take this and make it three points. And that's 6 points for Spain. So Spain will win their match against the Netherlands 16-9 here on cash. And in